Hello Horizons, welcome back. If there's one side quest that you have to do in Dragon's Dogma 2, that would be the Sphinx Riddles. Not only does it provide you with the best NPC interactions and dialogue in the game, but also rewards you with incredible loot. From hundreds of thousands of gold, weak stones to crystals, fairy stones and powerful equipment. And you can do it very early on in the game as well. So in this video, I will give you a full walkthrough of the entire questline, show you all the riddles and solutions, and take a flight together with the Sphinx. Now, let's get started. First, I want to talk about preparations. You should at least reach the first main city, Venworth. You can easily get here within the first few hours of the main story. Additionally, you should also get some fairy stones. We will need to use them at least twice, so two is minimum. But I recommend you make it 4 for round trips to save some time on traveling. A port crystal would also be good. It's not mandatory as we will be getting 2 of them from this quest. And finally, the tricky part is to find out where you found your first seeker's token. We want to do this before we meet the Sphinx, because once we start the riddle, we will be on the timer. The best way to do this is using an interactive map, and retrace your steps in the beginning area of the game, such as Mouth. I will link the one I used in the description below. Once you find the place you think is the right one, mark it on the map so you can quickly travel back and reach the place when you are told to do so during the quest. Now that the preps are done, let's head off. Starting from West Vinborg's Oxar Station, the ox cart will take us to Checkpoint Rest Town.
This ox cart's bound for the Checkpoint Rest Town.
Once you reach the town, I highly recommend you to head to the inn and take a rest, so you have a hard save. On the next day from the Checkpoint Rest Town, for the main road, we will be walking to this Riftstone of Fellowship. Once we arrive, we can find the Riftstone just inside of the tower. Let's enter. From here, click on Pawns in the Rift. And we can see a lot of pawns with the name Sphinx Mother, Sphinx Father, or Sphinx Parent. They are the pawns we are after. Just choose the one fit to your level and hire him or her. This will be important for one of the riddles.
If ever you've need of an ear to listen, you have but to ask.
Once we have the pawn, exit the rift and continue on. From the map, we'll be following the main road. Take the small path to the north, and we are going all the way to the ancient battleground. When you see this ballista, that means we have arrived. We want to take the side road on the left here.
'Tis a ballista arisen.
Now, if it's the first time you are in this area, you will find a Drake below us on the ground. Just ignore him for now. Onto the stronghold from the opening here, and turn left. Go up the stairs and the ladders. You can see a blue lamp. This is our clue of where to go. From the left, you can see a ladder, and that's a shortcut to where we want to go. But again, if it's the first time you're here, the ladder won't be dropped. So let's continue down here and climb down this ladder.
There's a ladder here. Perhaps new discoveries await us above.
On the left is the shortcut to the outside, but we are going right. Up these stairs again. And the ladders.
Ah, I'll take that. We might find a use for it.
Now we have arrived on the top of the stronghold. For the reference, this is where we are on the map. Now go up the ladder on the left. Jump down from the gap. And turn left to enter this cave. Now from here, our goal is to cross all the way to the other end of the cave. The rest path is very linear, so let's speed it up. Now, we have finally reached the destination. As you can see, I also dropped the port crystal here, and I recommend you to do so as well.
I don't know about you, Master.
For reference, here is our current location on the map.
But I'm worn out. Mightn't we have a rest before pressing on?
Now we are ready, let's go up and talk to the Sphinx.
Your resolve is commendable. The fool beholds a sage in the mirror. The sage a fool. Which is it you see, I wonder?
Now go up to her and take the first challenge, the Riddle of Eyes.
Our eyes are our allies. Yet oft do they betray, for eyes tell lies. So I advise, and thence do lead astray. Yet, how will your eyes advise you? Venture through yonder door, and retrieve that which is of greatest value.
This one requires us to go down to the crib she just opened and find one item for her. Let's just go down here.
We've got goblins.
Kill the first few enemies as we enter and turn back, look up. There's a chest hidden up there. Climb up from the left and claim the item. Sealing file. Head back to the Sphinx and give her the item.
So, this is your choice? The greatest worth your eyes describe? Indeed, this is what I sought. Your eyes see true. No greater worth can there be than that found in simplicity? As promised, I shall bestow upon you a prize. Collect it from yon chest and take this file too. Its purpose I shan't divulge. How you use it is up to you.
And she will reward you with a weak stone. The second is the Riddle of Madness.
Love is as twin to madness, they say. They are bound fast as night is today. So bring forth your most beloved to me, that I might gauge the depth of your insanity.
This one requires you to bring someone you have reached a high affinity. It can be any NPC you've done all quests with, or conveniently, our main pawn as well. Just pick her up and put on the podium. Talk to her again and she will reward you with a port crystal.
Not half bad. Yet only one you bring? I thought you capable of more.
The third riddle, Riddle of Wisdom.
The parent knows the child, yet the reverse is far from true. The child knows not the parent. Such is the parent's due. I am a lost child, for kinship do I yearn. So bring to me my parent, that I might better learn.
She's looking for a parent. So now is the pawn Sphinx mother we hired earlier to be of use. Pick her up and put on the podium. Talk to the Sphinx again and she will reward you with 1200 roof crystals.
Indeed, you are correct. All is in the name.
The fourth riddle, Riddle of Conviction.
Life is an enigma, a lender of mortal debt. Yet lighter pack makes fleet of foot and challenge nimbly met. So grant to me what you most prize, and thence elude your ponderous demise.
She wants us to give her our most valuable item. You can actually give her anything, but I highly recommend giving her the pot crystal, as she will give us a surprise.
Such generosity deserves a reward, methinks. Why don't you take a peek in yon chest?
In the chest, she gives us another pot crystal and returns the one we just gave her, so anything we give her will basically be duplicated. We just earned $3 worth of items. Now, the final riddle here is Rumination.
Is ever the first we keep fond in our breast, and ever the first that eclipses the rest. You know of the Seeker's tokens, I trust. Those keepsakes of a fondly remembered journey. Yet where was it that you found your first? Retrace your steps, if you can. You might make a new discovery. 7 days, shall we say, ere you return? May your journey be a pleasant one.
Here is our cue to go back to the place where we found our first Seeker's token. And we have 7 in-game days as time limit. If you have done the preparation correctly, it should be easy enough for you now. Please know that it will be in different places for each person. I found mine in a place to the east of Venworth, which I completely forgot and took me hours to retrace my steps. But if you're right, you'll find a finder's token in said location. Bring her back the token, you will be rewarded with 3 fairy stones.
I trust it was a pleasant jaunt. As promised, you shall have your prize. Look for it in yon chest.
Now from here, all 5 riddles are answered. She will start to fly away. But what we want to do here is to quickly grab and climb onto her back to catch a ride so that we don't have to walk all the way to her next location. She will start to fly as soon as the dialogue is over, so make sure you're ready.
I bid you farewell, dogged adventurer.
Not bad.
Now there we go, we are flying with her. Don't worry about our pawns, I'm sure they will find their way to us through the rift. Worth mentioning that we didn't really have a chance to open our final chest, so you can decide to change the order you do the riddles to get the rewards you want first.
Not half bad.
Now here we have arrived at the second location. For reference, this is where we are on the map. You can of course walk here from our first location via checkpoint Reston, but the journey would be very long and difficult, especially if you are doing this at a lower level. I do recommend you to swap to a vocation that can use a bow for the later fight, but it's not mandatory. Okay, from the get-go, we already have one chest open as finding her is your first riddle here, Riddle of Reunion. You will be rewarded with 100,000 gold, which is quite a hefty sum. But before we talk to her again, let's step out of the shrine and put down a port crystal. It is mandatory for the ways we will be using to solve some later riddles, so please remember to do that. From here, the order of riddles will be random. Let's see what she has for us now.
How easily the mind unravels. Some say it's pain that does it best, others darkness. But I say neither. Rather, I say a mind cannot be more soundly broken than when it beholds its earnest efforts laid low in a single stroke. Could you survive such despair? We shall see. Here, I have an amphora destined for Sir Moritz in Batal. Deliver it to him, but beware, it's rather fragile. I do hope your struggle will amuse.
So, this is Riddle of Futility. We need to deliver this fragile vase to a person in Back Batal. It's an extremely difficult task, so instead, we will bring the person here. Travel to Back Batal, use any means you have at your disposal, location of the person will be marked on your map. So let's just head there. There he is, Moritz. Pick him up. We can't use Fairy Stone here, so step out to the stairs and teleport to the port crystal we put down earlier. I'll drop Moritz next to the vase, and the riddle will be completed.
Well, well. The amphora has been delivered intact. I'd not thought you had it in you.
And the reward is a ring, Eternal Bond, which will give you a boost to affinity with others. Okay, let's hear the next riddle.
So vast is this world, and full of life. You are but one of many. Indeed, in the grand scheme, we are as distinct from one another as pebbles on a beach. Yet we do so love to extol our differences. But are these differences so great? If you believe so, this next task should prove exceedingly simple. I seek this man. If men are so distinct, I'm sure you'll find him in a trice.
This is a funny one. Riddle of Differentiation. You might have seen this person before, but there are actually two of them. They are twins, both in Checkpoint Reston. Dante lives on the Vermont side of the town. You can find him wandering around outside the inn we stayed at before. He has straight hair with fringe covering left forehead. While his brother, Virgil, lives on the Batao side of the town. He has curly waves with fringe covering his right forehead. So in our case, it was Virgil Sphinx wounded. Same as before, pick him up and fast travel back. Talk to Sphinx and ask for the verdict.
Then I shall weigh its merit.
This is uncanny. As a reward, we will get Whimsical Daydream, a quite nice trickster sensor. Here comes the next riddle, the Riddle of Contest.
Though ours is a battle of wits, tests of metal are more to your strength. Is that not so? Come, try your arm, though he shall be your opponent, not I. However, I am not one to be amused by a simple duel. Bear this ring into battle, that I might gauge your true strength.
This fight won't be fair. We will be forced to wear the Ring of Dehision, which basically reduces our damage to nothing. But we don't have to fight fair either. We just have to do this. As a reward, we will get a Ring of Ambition, a great accessory for leveling. Do remember to unequip the Ring of Dehision so we won't be useless later on. Now, here comes the final riddle. It can only be the Riddle of Recollection.
Now, questions beget questions, and I have one for you. How many riddles have you solved thus far? My memory fails me, you see. Remind me, and make it plain. Let yonder statues be your means. For every question aptly answered, bring one here before me.
The easiest way to find out how many riddles we have done is to count how many chests the hunter has been opened, and then plus 5 riddles we did in the first zone, and you will have the answer. So in my case of this video, it will be 9. Put 9 statues before her and ask for the reward.
My, that's quite a number. And the correct one, no less. I see you're keeping track.
After 9 riddles, she will start to fly away. Be ready. We don't want her to live. We still need that sweet, sweet reward in that big golden chest. So start attacking as she starts to fly, and she will accept the challenge.
It will bring me no pleasure to spill your blood, but nor can I ignore so bold a challenge.
Before we start fighting, do remember to open the chest from the last riddle, as that will give us an unmaking arrow. This fight is yet another riddle. She is a sphinx. Her body has human half and a beast half. We cannot attack her human half, or she will flee the battle regardless. So make sure to only attack her lower body, legs and wings. It could be a bit of grind, but given time, I'm sure you will have it. Although, if you have made a mistake in battle, and some stray bullets hit her in the face and chest, She will state her disappointment and announce her departure.
I shall suffer this no longer. I'd hoped for some sport.
I cannot say whether our path was the right one.
Don't panic. Open the menu, equip the unmaking arrow we got earlier, draw our bow to the fullest, and make sure to strike true. This ought to end her nice and quick. The reward will be 10,000 gold and a key of sagacity. This will open a golden chest for us. Now congratulations, you have acquired the Eternal Wakestone. This is one big solution to the Dragon Plagues, so keep it safe. Do remember though, it still breaks after one use. Now there you have it. These are the solutions to all Sphinx riddles, how you can defeat her in battle and claim all the rewards. Let me know in the commentary below which one of the riddles is your favorite and the most difficult for you to solve. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave a like and subscribe for more content gaming. This is Xing. As always, thanks for watching and see you next time.